We believe that agricultural transformation is critical for inclusive economic growth in Africa. And to be able to achieve agricultural transformation, digitalization can be a key aspect of this transformation. So digitalization for agriculture is really how to modernize smallholder agriculture and help in improving productivity, income, resilience to climate change, and also create opportunities for young people and women in terms of including them in the agricultural value chain. There are a lot of innovations coming up in terms of the digital innovations. For example, it's with a lot of data becoming easily accessible through satellites, through mobile phones, and so on. Farmers can have up-to-date information on what's happening on the ground in terms of the status of the soil, the status of the crops, where are the gaps for fertilizers and so on. And with that, you can really have targeted inputs that will help to improve productivity while, costs are also maintained at a low level. So we have technologies that allow to offer extension and advisory services that help farmers to access markets, that help farmers to access finance. So through all these facilities, digitalization can really transform smallholder agriculture. For an individual farmer, it's very expensive. But when we are organized and with support from governments and donors, they can access quite expensive weather-related, satellite information. So the more organized the farmers are, the better they can exploit in terms of technology as well as benefit from the value chain, adding more value and taking a bigger share of the value chain. We looked at more than 390 solutions that are active in the market at the moment in sub-Saharan Africa. And what we found is still there is quite a significant donor investment in this area, but there's also private sector investment. So, for example, we found out that the private sector is at the moment about 150 million a year, but the potential when you look at the addressable market is to the extent of 2.3 billion. The role of government, especially in terms of improving what we call the digital for agriculture infrastructure, in terms of digital soil maps, digital profiles of farmers and so on, that are really the basis for providing efficient digital services. And the enabling environment as well is very important in terms of the policy. So countries that are very supportive to digital innovations, have the right policy, the right investment, the right infrastructure and so on, have shown great advance in this area. So in our report, we see 10, 12 countries in Africa that are making really good progress, whereas the rest of the countries are still very, very having very slow movement in this area.
Is there like a counterintuitive country that's doing very well, even though it's very small?
Well, I think it's obvious in terms of size. Rwanda is a small country, but it's one of the most successful in this area. So it's not really the size, it's really more the policy, the investment, and the climate for entrepreneurship in this area.